love letters and official invitations, written with fountain pens or felt-tip pens. This small startup in Berlin and its half dozen employees are helping to keep the dying art of penmanship alive.
Handwriting is a personal expression. It's like a person's voice, something really private and individual.
It's a lot of fun, and it's a lot more personal than all the computer correspondence.
Schreibstadt was founded in Berlin 2 years ago. Today it has more than 60 employees, most of them women. Many have no training in penmanship, just a special talent. Each day, these scribes produce around 2,000 handwritten business letters, invitations, and place cards.
What do we need penmanship for nowadays? Take me. I'd scribble a few notes on a piece of paper, or maybe I'd send a postcard while on vacation. But try writing an entire letter. Penmanship like that just doesn't exist anymore.
Whether it's a Valentine's Day card, a greeting in old-fashioned German script, skilled calligraphy, or a handwritten business letter, demand for good penmanship is on the rise. One reason is that handwritten letters demand more attention than printed ones do.
Who writes someone a personal letter? Usually good friends or someone that really wants to put in that extra time for someone. And that person receiving it, he thinks, okay, someone's really gone out of their way and taken their time to do this. And then they open it up and read it.
This is the handwriting of German author Heinrich von Kleist. But the person behind the pen is Miriam Zachs. She's an expert in copying people's penmanship. She especially likes to copy the handwriting of famous authors, but she also copies the handwriting of people she admires.
Handwriting has always fascinated me, even when I was a child. In school, my German teacher used to write in beautiful handwriting. Now I know that she was a fan of Goethe, because her handwriting looked a lot like Goethe's. I admired her so much. I used to practice writing like her. It's a little like crawling into someone's mind.
Miriam is also an actor and a theater director. She often uses her penmanship in her plays, like this play written by Kleist. She also writes lines for films and museum exhibitions. She's turned her talent for imitation into a business. Miriam has just recently mastered the penmanship of Germany's most famous poet, Johann Wolfgang von Goethe. The angular, angst-written handwriting of Austrian writer Franz Kafka is another of her specialties.
He crossed his T's with a hard, violent stroke, like he wanted to execute the word he'd just written.
Nicolas Auchinier's flowing penmanship is a bit easier on the eyes. The Frenchman is a small star in the world of calligraphy. For the past 11 years, he's written invitations for big fashion events. Clients can choose from a variety of penmanship styles. And Auchinier recently launched his own line of pens for a French fashion label.
If you have the choice between a ballpoint and a good fountain pen, I think you should always choose the fountain pen. With a fountain pen, you are forced to think more about the words you're writing. Simply because ink is forever.
The penmanship business is booming. In Berlin, Torsten Petzold's Schreibstadt has expanded its services to include an online store. Customers can order a handwritten letter for 30 euros, and you can have a card handwritten for 8 euros. The one thing that the penmanship company does not do is come up with what to say. Even if it doesn't come from your own pen, it does have to come from your own heart